What is a fact that can possibly save your life? Maybe not your life, but someone else's. Most drowning is silent. The victim quite literally cannot speak to call for help, as they are too desperately trying to get any air at all. Drowning can look simply like a person bobbing in the water until they no longer come back up. Keep a watch out, especially if it's kids. If you get impaled or stabbed, leave the object and then call 911, or your country's equal. That object is keeping all the blood on the inside of your body. Also, if it's an open stab wound where they took the object out, you can put a credit card or gift card in the slot. Edit. Do not. I repeat. Do not do this. Please. I mixed it up, I think. I think you are supposed to put the card over to create a vacuum. Sorry, I am very tired and sleep deprived. Single quote. What kind of wide-ass knives are you getting stabbed with? You just have to kinda like mash it in there. If the wound is still bleeding, wrap cloth around the impaled object to try and stem the flow of blood. You can look up how to do a donut wrap. It's super quick and easy. If your cloth saturated with blood, cover it with another. Never take off a bandage. Double check advices in this thread with your own research. If you ever almost drown to the point of throwing up water or passing out, even if you feel 100% fine, get to a hospital. Your lungs can unwittingly self-fill up with fluid over the next few hours. Secondary drowning is no joke. More people definitely need to be aware of the dangers. All firearms are loaded. Even if they are not, they are. 1,000 times, yes. My father shot himself in the foot because the gun he checked multiple times had a BB in the chamber that didn't rattle. He shot at his foot because he wanted to see how strong the air pressure was. It ended with a trip to the emergency room and a police report. We're thankful it was only a BB gun that time. The next time he went to the ER for a gun wound, it was because he overloaded a black powder rifle. He took off a chunk of his right arm. Sure, he's lucky he didn't take out part of the artery. Why he's still allowed to have guns baffles me. If lost in the woods, always follow water downstream, monsieur. Why? Because civilization is often built around rivers, and streams join together to eventually become rivers. Odds are pretty good that, unless you are in a truly remote area like northern Canada or Alaska, that you will eventually find some form of civilization downstream eventually. Access to clean drinking water. Non-polluted moving water is often okay to drink in an emergency. Always test by having a sip and waiting for your body to react before drinking. And food in the form of stream-side vegetation is also helpful. And lastly, running water doesn't circle back around. You can't get turned around so long as you have running water to follow. You'll end up downstream. Breaking news. Hundreds of bodies found downstream of river. Police on the lookout for the downstream rive serial killer. If your car goes into the water, open the door or roll down the windows immediately. If you don't, the pressure differential will hold them shut and you'll have to wait until the car fills up with water. Your car will turn upside down when it fills with water, so you could drown before that even happens. Side on Mythbusters. Yep, that's why you want to get out while your car is still bobbing on the surface. I read somewhere if a stranger gets in your car and tells you to take them somewhere, drive into something like a lamppost or anything, you won't be useful to them anymore because the car is damaged and you've drawn attention to them by crashing the car. You'll damage your car, but you'll have your life in your bank account. Someone at my college did this a few years ago. The guy told him to drive to the bank and withdraw all his money, so he drove into a lamppost and saved himself. Don't do this if you're an Uber driver. My wife was born and raised in Colombia. Her dad is a doctor. Back in the 90s, some of his cousins kidnapped him in order to steal his money and kill. Hi, monsieur, he faked a heart attack and they panicked. Ended up tossing him out of the car. He's still with us today. Colombians are some crazy motherfuckers. When having a heart attack, you don't swallow aspirin, you chew it. Is this real? gets to the bloodstream faster through the walls of the mouth. If you get kidnapped, try to leave as much traces of yourself behind as you can. For example, leave bits of clothing behind or scratch your arms a lot to leave dead skin behind. This way you increase your chances that a search dog could pick up your scent and find you. I watched a crime show once where the victim left her hair everywhere in her abductor's car. She kept pulling single strands of hair out. When she was taken to the house of the person who took her, she pulled more hair out, touched everything she could to leave fingerprints behind, and even licked multiple places in his house. She managed to escape and they found evidence of her all over his car and house. Slam shut case. I wish I could remember her name so I could look her case up. Not idly do the leaves of Lorien fall. You could also punch out a taillight from the trunk you're in and wave to following motorists. Also try to never go to a second location. If you call 911 even though you don't have signal, it will work. Yeah, I hate this on movies when they're just slightly out of a town and need emergency services. There's no cell service, bitch, just go ahead and try anyway. Greater than cell phones require network coverage to make calls. However, if the usable strength of the mobile network of your service provider, the manufacturer, company of the SIM card that you are using, is not good enough at the place where you're making the call, then they use the network of some other service provider whose usable signal strength is strong enough to make the call. Greater than GSM technology. Most SIM cards work on GSM nowadays. Is designed in such a way that you can use the network of another service provider in the absence of network coverage from your own service provider, but your access to it will be limited. Hence the emergency call restriction. And this is how it works. Wow, I never knew this. To jump on this, you can also call emergency services on an old phone without a SIM card in it. You can do so with most carriers. In many countries, several parents I know give their children their old phones for emergency use. They can't text friends, but they can call 911 in case anything happens. If someone falls to very cold water, you need to heat them up periodically. Putting them next to a fire or such will kill them, monsieur. I would like to add that if your finger, toes are frostbitten or almost frostbitten, do not run them under hot water. Warm them up slowly. To add to this, if your fingers or toes are frostbitten or almost frostbitten, and you expect that it will happen again in the short time, you're better off not trying to warm them up at all. You should keep them cold. The freezing and then unfreezing and refreezing, and ice crystals expanding and contracting in your tissue can do more damage than if you just let your fingers and toes stay icy. Did you mean periodically or gradually? Probably said already, bad CPR is better than no. Even if you're unskilled, you literally cannot make the person more dead, as being dead is what predicates CPR. If you have a puncture wound to the chest or abdomen, the first thing you should do is place a non-porous, think plastic bag, object over the wound. It will help prevent tension pneumothorax. A tourniquet is quite simple to put on and can save a life if there is no other option. Place close to the site or near, not on a joint. Never remove a tourniquet once placed, as clots can travel to the brain and lungs. Also mark the time you put it on. If you're at an accident scene and have no medical training, something you can do is collect information and help calm victims. This is quite helpful as it assists the paramedics with triage and keeps potential injured persons' heart rates down. Alternatively, learn how to hold C's spine. If your car ever gets stuck on the train tracks, look for a sign on the crossing arms. This is the railway 911 and has a number to call to stop traffic as well as your exact location. If you've been cut deeply, pack gauze into the wound as tightly as possible, then hold pressure. If you are driving in inclement weather, pay attention to truckers. They are often warned ahead of time of wrecks and things due to their radios. Also, never drive in the rain without headlights. If the ocean is retreating, there's a tsunami coming, evacuate the beach immediately. Or if you experience a large earthquake near the coast, you should evacuate, as earthquakes are one of, if not the leading causes of tsunamis. If you have a heart attack, cough. A paramedic taught me that, and I'm not sure about the science behind it, but he brought up three instances where it saved someone's life, so I guess it works. Never dig straight down. Terrarians have to disagree. Never pull out a gun or any weapon unless you are prepared to kill or die. Weapons escalate the situation to another level. If you have a weapon, intend to use it and risk having it used on you. Speaking with first-hand experience, North Korean border guards will search your belongings when you are going into the country. If you want to sneak something illegal in, e.g. South Korean movies, hide them in a pillow. At least that's how I managed to do it. Actually, just don't go to North Korea. Trust me, greater than at least that's how I managed to do it. Kim Jong-un wants to know your location. If you smell a fish smell in your house, some people also report a urine-like smell. For no reason. 9 times out of 10 it means there's an electrical fire. Wash your hands frequently for at least 20 seconds. Don't touch your face. Wear a mask if you go out. Stay indoors and practice physical distancing. Chipotle by my house no longer requires mask. I'm so pissed that they careless about their employees. Maybe not your life, but possibly others. In an emergency situation, pick one person to specifically call 911. In lots of stressful or emergency situations, there are significant delays in calling 911. Some people assume that others will call 911 while others panic, freeze up, and don't think to call 911. If you're faced with an situation where 911 is necessary, pick a specific person to contact 911. Wasn't that a psychological effect? If no one is chosen, there's a high chance no one will do anything, because they all think the others will do so. Is it the bystander effect? Yes. The larger the group, the worse it gets, but even saying something as dumb as, "Hey fatso in the red shirt," 911 now tends to override the need to whine about being called fat, and they will almost certainly call, then whine about it later. This is a New Zealand specific one, but all emergency numbers work here. The official number is 111, but 999,911, etc. will all work. This is so that tourists can still reach emergency services easily. I live in Central Europe. When you dial 911 here, it just redirects you to our number, 112. The barrel of the gun faces away from you. CO poisoning exists and buildings should be tested. If you are stuck in an airtight room, compartment, you will die of CO2 poisoning before you run out of oxygen. Wait, like a plane. New fear unlocked. Just open a window and let fresh air in. The window will not open, but I think this door next to my seat will. Carbon dioxide, aka CO2, is an essential component of the animal underscore plant gas exchange. Perhaps you meant CO, carbon monoxide, which will kill air-breathing creatures like us. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.